Hello, this is Nick Marine, and welcome to Let's Read Japanese, course series for the reading of Japanese text alongside its audio counterpart. All right, so today's video is going to be Kino Nani Tabita, episode 7. So this episode 7 of a 12 episode season. Since this is the 7th episode, what I'll do is a bit more of a detailed entry, a bit more detailed intro. All right, so the way this is going to work, this is a Let's Read Japanese. So the idea is I'm going to read along Japanese text. So let me just show you that one there. All right. So these are normally subtitles ripped from TV shows. It could also be the digital book version. So I'm reading along with this too, and then up above is going to be the audio playing that I'll be reading along to. Normally it's the TV show the subs came from, but it could also be the audiobook version of the book that I'm reading. All right, so I'm reading along with the audio. Benefit there, it's just easier to comprehend, and it's easier for retention and comprehension, just doing that alone with nothing else. The other benefit is going to be because I have control of it, if I see something in the sentence is kind of being problematic, I can pause the audio and like reread or I can even replay the audio as I reread the sentence, try to make sure I can parse the information better. And then finally, if it comes to a word I don't know, I can just hover over it like this right here. And then I can see either a Japanese definition like we see here, pop-up dictionary called Yomi-chan. It's got some dictionary plugins. You can see, but you can also go and look at the, there can also be an English Japanese entries as well. So you have both those options there. Cool. So the benefit there is it allows me to then not be limited to TV shows within my level. I can actually watch TV shows and read books that are above my current Japanese level because I'm just looking at words I don't know, which allows essentially now the entire book is comprehensible within reason. Okay. Yeah, the other benefit is after you've done doing a read through like this, let's say for an hour's worth, read for an hour, or you watch a half hour of a show or an hour of a show, however you want to do it, but go back and then re-experience that the way it was meant to be done. So either actually read the book with audio but without pausing, or watch a TV show with subtitles, or you know, if you want to read however you want to do it, read the book with or without audio, watch a TV show with or without Japanese subtitles, however you want to do it. But you'll find it is a much higher level of comprehension. You're able to comprehend it at a much higher level. So that's a really big benefit when it comes to immersion, because the one thing that you get from immersion is the key word that people sometimes forget is comprehensible immersion. If what you're immersing in is not comprehensible, then it might as well be white noise. Your brain just is not going to process it in a way to where it can put the information slots where it can memorize and access it for later to help with later comprehension of other material, if that makes sense. Okay, so with that said, like I said, this is going to be episode 7, which we are on. And yeah, let's get right into it. All right, so what I'll say is, like, if you end up enjoying this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and like. If you enjoy the series that I'm doing with this, you'd like to see more, subscribe to the channel. I'll make more like this, most likely. Finally, this is part of the Let's Learn Japanese project. Now, if you like that project, what I'm doing, helping the Japanese learning community, you can support that via the Patreon, so the links are below. In addition, there's links to the Let's Learn Japanese website, Otaku Day put together, the Let's Learn Japanese community Discord, and finally, there, if you want to hire me on commission, the hourly rates and the payments are done via Patreon as well, just at a different, for a different reason. But again, it's by the hour. And when I say, usually it's going to be as technical assistance or advice. Most people hire me just to get started, you know, because getting Anki set up and getting some of these spreadsheets set up and getting some of these decks with Anki set up can be kind of complicated. Maybe even setting up something as simple as the, not saying simple, something like, learning languages with the Japanese plugins, stuff like that. Some of these other resources that are available that you may not be aware of or know how to set up quickly on your system. Again, I kind of helped walk people through that. That's just what that's all about. So nothing, it's not really teaching Japanese. It's teaching how to teach yourself Japanese. So there you go. Okay, with that longer introduction out of the way, let's get into it. This is episode 7. Let's see, we're in June. So it's been about I think the first episode starts in June. Could be wrong. So it's been about a year's time has passed.
Aratamemashite.
One more time. Aratamemashite. Yeah, start from the beginning.
Kenji desu.
Kenji desu.
Hajimemashite.
Yoyaku owai dekimashita ne.
Kohinata-san.
Where are we at?
Otoko-ppokute ii kanji.
お二人のことはシロさんからよく聞いてたんです。
どんな風にネタにされたりしてない？
ネタに、ああ、何
ネタにされたりしてない？
渡るね。
あの、普通に話してただけですよ。
ジルベール渡る、
ジルベール渡る、
ほんと聞いてたまんま、
聞いてまんま。
なんすか？
いやいや、あ、これお近づきの印に。ニューヨーク。
That's a nearby. 近づき、近づき、近づきの印。There, that one. Get to know each other better.お近づきの印に入浴剤、入浴剤、バスオーツ。
お近づきの印に入浴剤。
うわー、嬉しい。俺こういうの大好き。
あ、本当。ありがとうございます。
あ、いいえ。こっちがグラマラスブラックベリー。これはフォレストグリーンシャワー。
どうしよう。ベリー系だよね。
え？
ベリー系？うん。
なんで大ちゃんが決めるの？俺だってたまには草っぽいの試してみようかなとか思うかもしんないじゃん。
ごめんごめん、じゃあ両方渡るくんが使えばいいよ。
またそういう感じ。大ちゃん最近何でも譲りゃいいと思ってない？めんどくさいと思ってない？大ちゃん最近何でも譲りゃいいと思ってない？めんどくさいと思ってない？
そんなことないよ。
そんなことあるって。
なんでそんなことないって言った
ら。最近ずっとそればっかだから。
あの、
それ
はさっきから、ね、なんか頼みますか？
あ、店こんな感じでよかったですか？勝手に決めちゃいましたけど。
いや、助かりました。こういうとこ俺はよく知らなくて。
筧さん、今日もシュッとしちゃったな。
渡る。
筧さん、今日もシュッとしちゃったな。
でしょ？
でしょ？
お前晩飯まうだろ。なんか食うか。
渡るくんお腹空いた？
うん、食べる。
揃った
。へえ、小日向さんって芸能プロダクションの人なんだ。そうなんだ、知らん。へえ、小日向さんって芸能プロダクションの人なんだ。そうなんだ、知らなかった。忙しそうな仕事ですよね。
今はそうでもないですよ。まあマネージャーやってた頃はそれはもう昼も夜もなかったですけど。
女性アイドル夜中の2時に彼氏の家に送って、朝まで車で待ってたりしてたんだよね。
うん。
朝まで女性アイドル夜中の2時に彼氏の家に送って、朝まで車で待ってたりしてたんだよね。
ひどい。
やっぱそういうのってあるんだ。
タレントを守るのが仕事ですから。
うん。
なるほど。理不尽な仕打ちにも忍耐強いのは職業柄か。
理不尽。 婦人や。Conduct, 仕打ちに。忍耐強い。我慢強い。Be able to bear. Okay. Persevering, patient. Gara. Shokugyo gara. Okay. Rifujin na.
Rifujin na shiuchi ni mo nintai zuyoi.
Rifujin na shiuchi ni mo.
Rifujin na shiuchi ni mo nintai zuyoi no wa.
Nintai zuyoi no wa.
理不尽な仕打ちにも忍耐強いのは職業柄か。
職業柄か。
小日向さん、ここに書いてある名前って。
ああ、担当しているタレントです。
三谷真美も。
はい。真美は10年ぐらいマネージャーでついてました。
マジで？俺大ファンなんですよ。いや、三谷真美がデビューした時の衝撃って言ったらもう。あのポニーテールのクラゲ、あれ反則、あれ。
ポニーテール、クラゲ、I guess、クラゲ、いや、ポニーテール、but、短く、loose hair、ポニーテールのクラゲ、クラゲ。
ポニーテールの衝撃って言ったらもう、あのポニーテールのクラゲ、あれ反則、あれ。
希望
罪ですよ。この間の大河ドラマも良かったな。
大河ドラマ。さが大河。大河 ドラマ。
俺あんまテレビ。この間の大河ドラマも良かったな。俺あんまテレビ見る方じゃないんですけど。あ、良かったですよね。になった。
かけ。
わお。
さんってさ、倍なの。
倍なの。
え？女も好きなの？
いや、それはないですよ。ほら、ゲイでも女の子のアイドルグループのファンとかよくあるじゃないですか。あれですよ、あれ。
でもな、シロさんの好みの女の子アイドルって。ベタにのんけの男の子たちが好きになるタイプなんだよね。
Kind of creepy what he's doing with the paper from the straw. ベタに。ね。What is ベタ or ベタに。のんけ。のんけ。
ベタにのんけの男の子たちが好きになるタイプなんだよね。
確かに三谷真美は芸好きする子じゃないですね。
でも倍じゃない。
確かに三谷真美は芸好きする子じゃないですね。
でも倍じゃないんだって言ってるだろ。
なんか筧さんってさ、見た目も話し方も中身も全然ゲイっぽくない。王道から全部外れてる。見た目も話し方も中身も全然ゲイっぽくない。王道から全部外れてる。
王道から。
王道から全部外れてる。
I wonder if that's a phrase itself. 王道から。No, it's not showing.
どうそれはゲイのど真ん中にはなれませんよ。それはゲイのど真ん中にはなれませんよ。 マイノリティのさらにマイナーな方ですよ。
Should be at minus, right? Minor. Minor. Okay, minor.
マイノリティのさらにマイナーな方ですよ。
でもそれって便利だよね。
え？
チーズ。ゲイってさ、何が面倒いって、ゲイじゃないふりするために。
する。
いろんな嘘つかない、ゲイじゃないふりするためにいろんな嘘つかなきゃいけないことなんだよね。学生の時なんか友達と好きな女の子のタイプとか芸能人なら誰がいいとかどういうファッションが好きとかそういう話になるじゃん。大抵のゲイはさそういうのに全部嘘つかないとゲイだってことを隠して生きていけないからすっごく苦しいんだよね。でも武井さんって自分がゲイだってこと以外ほとんど嘘ついたことないでしょ。
まあそうかも。
ゲイファッションに興味ないし言葉遣いも普通だしね。
三ツ矢真美も好きですし、
うん、そう考えると志保さんってちょっとずるいかも。俺なんて昔から本当はアイドルなら男の子が好きだし
本当は
ピンク大好きだし言葉も気が緩むと出ちゃうし。
気が緩む、うん、
ピンク大好きだし言葉も気が緩むと出ちゃうし。
お前もともと全然隠してないだろ。
そんなことない。俺だって高校の時まではそれなりにこう隠したり悩んだりしてたよ。
そこなりにこう See if that's a full phrase、
oh. それなりにこう隠したり悩んだりしてたよ。
うん、
Actually, see, それなりに
加計さん今も隠してるんだ。
まあ職場では。
加計さんみたいなタイプって普段が普通だからいざカミングアウトするってなると めちゃくちゃ恥ずらがっちゃうんだ
周りは1ミリもゲイだとは思ってないでしょうからね。
それも面倒っちゃ面倒かね、加計さん。
うん、
まあね。
But I think with him though, the problem isn't that so much hiding as he's trying to also maybe make them think that he's not gay, as opposed to just not telling them he's gay. There is a difference. I mean, because like I said, I mean, you can have keep your stuff personally, so you just don't make your personal life, you know.Keep your personal life personal. That's different than、if someone asks you, you just like, you just don't mention, like, are you seeing someone?、yes, I am. You just don't have to talk about them, what they're like or whatever. Just, you know, just keep it personal. And it feels kind of, probably feels weird and standoffish, maybe. But, you know. That seemed almost a little normal.
嬉しいんだもん。
上機嫌。上に機嫌。
えらく上機嫌だな。
うん、
だって嬉しいんだもん。何が？
ゲイの友達同士で2対2で食事なんて今まで一度もなかったじゃん。しかも外に。
そうだっけ？
そうだ。
ああ、すっごい楽しかった。でもあのジルベール渡るはやっぱ食えないやつだったろ。あいつヘラヘラしながらドイツだよな。
まあね。
S type or M type? So he's more the sadist, the controlling type. Then M type would be, yeah, the other guy.
でも俺嫌いじゃないけど行こう。
え、何？雷？
これ降ってくるな。早く帰ろう。
待って。
待って。
We're already at 20 minutes, and I'm only like 20% of the way through the show. That's not a good sign.
ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
またいらしてください。
はい。
ケンちゃん。
はい。
もう予約入ってないしさ、今日上がっていいよ。
本当に？ああ、もうありがたい。
どうしたの？今日なんかずっとニヤニヤしてね。
え？実はね、今日シロさんが風邪ひいて寝てんの。
ああ。
昨日の雨で冷えちゃったみたいで。
風邪？
うん。
それがなんでいいことなんですか？彼氏さんしんどいだけじゃないですか。
いやだってほら、俺って尽くすタイプでしょ。なのにシロさん、基本何でもできる人だから、俺普段何もさせてもらえないわけよ。なのにシロさん、基本何でもできる人だから。俺普段何もさせてもらえないわけよ。だから今日は思う存分お世話できるって。
もう存分。See, that's full phrase. もう存分。もうこれで十分だと満足するまで。うん。もう一気に go over and beyond, more and beyond. Heart's content, satisfaction. もう存分。
だから今日は思う存分お世話できるって思うと。
ほっとこう。
嬉しくって嬉しくって。
ほっとこうほっとこう。ね。
男、
もう時間の無駄だから。
はーい。
まずは買い物だな。あ、スーパーの前にドラッグストアかな。待ってて、シロさん。ただいま、シロさん。早く帰ってきたよ。大丈夫？ひひひ、カティ。あ、いいのいいの、じっとしてて、じっと。
はい。
ちゃんとしてて。これをね、おでこに。ああピタッと貼るの。100回でしょ。ああ楽になったでしょ。ほらちゃんと寝たよ。ほら
ほら、ダメだよ。
冷えちゃったらダメなんだから
。しんどい。
お薬飲んだ。食欲あるかな。あ、晩ご飯俺が作るからね。その前に水枕作ろうか。
Hot water bottle? It's a water bottle. Oh, water pillow. 水枕。Yeah, yeah. That's it.
あれ気持ちいいから。
ケンジ。
お前、絶対楽しんでるだろう。と言いたいが、もう言うのもしんどい。
シロさん、いいんだよ、お礼なんて。待っててね。今晩御飯作るから。
Right, now we're a third of the way through. This is, yeah.
忘れ物。バカ。
とにかく寝よう。
よし。やるぞ。待っててね。絹ごし豆腐4分の1をレン。
Okay, 絹ごし, I know that's like the silk or the softer version of tofu. Yeah, soft tofu. 絹ごし豆腐。絹ごし豆腐4分の1。That's a quarter of it.
絹ごし豆腐4分の1をレンジで1分加熱して。
加熱して。
上からおもし。
So, キノゴシ豆腐、キノゴシ豆腐、キヌゴシ豆腐。
塩して、水切りしておく。これ、
水切り？ Let's see it there. Kind of squeeze out the liquids. Draining. There we go. 水切り。
上から重しをして水切りしておく。
I've never done that.
ほうれん草は根っこのところの泥を。
根っこ、that's from the root. Yeah, 根っこから。
よーく洗って落として。
Let me hear that again.
ほうれん草は根っこのところの泥をよーく洗って落として。
ああ、ケンジ、水出しすぎ。
テレビで見た卵焼きにチャレンジしますよ。ではまずはじめに合わせだしを作ります。
卵焼きチャレンジ何です。
水80
合わせだし。 Hear that one more time。
ではまずはじめに合わせだしを作ります。
合わせだし、 Let's see if that's a full phrase。
水 80cc 和風だしの素。
和風だし。
少々。醤油小さじ1。
小さじ just a teaspoon 小さじ
1。塩2つまみ。
2つまみ。
砂糖大さじ1杯半を。
大さじ1、
よーく混ぜます。ここからがポイントです。卵3個は菜箸の隙間を開けて。
菜箸？ Oh, okay. Vegetable 箸。 Okay, makes sense. 菜箸の隙間。
ボウルの底に白身をこすりつけてちぎるように。
ボウルの底にこすりつけて、
前後に10往復。1、2、3、4、5、6、7、8、9、10。
前後に10往復。
ボウルを90度回転させてまた前後に10往復。ここにさっきの合わせだしをダーッと入れて。
何や、合わせだし。Don't quite know what that's supposed to be, but okay.
また縦横10往復ずつ切るように混ぜます。
I know it's vertical and up and down, vertical and sideways, right? 縦横。Up and yeah, basically, yeah, same. Tateyoku, Jo and okay, let's hear that again.
Tateyoku, Jo.
Yeah, Tateyoku, but also Jo. Tateyoku.
往復ずつ切るように混ぜます。
ずつ。
あんまり混ぜすぎないようにするんですね。そう、それがコツなんですよ。
何一人で喋ってんだ。
さて、ここからが勝負だ。
勝負。
あらかじめ
ことを、stuff you do before it happens。 あらかじめ
サラダ油を染み込ませた、あらかじめサラダ油を染み込ませたキッチンペーパーを用意して、卵焼き用のフライパンを強火で1分加熱。ここで火を少し弱めてペーパータオルで油を引く。かなり熱くなってるな。そこにお玉一杯分の卵液を入れて、
Mess up something?
なんだなんだ、大丈夫か。
うわ、卵すごい急で焼けちゃってるんですけど。
Maybe too much heat?
大きな気泡焼き潰して表面。
Right, right. Yeah, so pop the bubbles, okay, for tamago yaki. Oh, yeah, now I remember, because this is the tamago yaki recipe you saw in the first, first episode where they explain how to make tamago yaki. Of Shinya Shokubo, that's right.
Doro ni natte kitara, oku kara temae ni mitsu. Hyoumen.大きな気泡だけ潰して表面がドロドロになってきたら奥から手前に三つ折りに畳む。
三つ折りに畳む。
ダメだ、柔らかすぎて箸じゃ全然返せない。
I'm wondering ifThere's another trick about where you put the heat at.
あれ、あれどこ？
Spatula.
どうしてないのね？ あ、あった。
There we go.
なんかぐちゃっとなっちゃった。
ぐちゃっと。
でも、とにかく手前に寄せて。ここで火をって弱火にしないのがジューシーに焼き上げるコツ。負けない。
It just takes, I guess, I'm assuming this takes practice, you know?
そしたら、もう一度奥に寄せて、空いたところに。
Alright, so I like that. I like the little recipe you showed, because I need to learn how to make tamago yaki, because it's, fairly straightforward. You saw it do it. You know, you're making shoyu, you add some, you're adding a little salt, a little sugar, and some other stuff. I know, I forgot how everything is. But again, you saw it, like, mix up the eggs, then the sauce, put it together, have that mixed up. You're adding a ladle of eggs to the heat to make the initial roll. And then as you add some more and then roll that into it and add maybe one more and roll that into it.So if that kind of makes sense, and then either, I guess you can save the rest, and, you know, use it as you go along. So it's not like you got to cook everything in the egg bowl that you've mixed yet. So you just do it at part by part, which actually kind of makes sense.
もう一度、空いたところに、もう一度。
Yeah, you see how he's half the pan, and then you fill that up with the pan.With the next set of eggs, and then you can roll that into it. I'm guessing, like, though he's got the fire up too high. I could be wrong. Like I said, I've never really done this.
2杯分の卵液を流し込んで、わあ、あっという間に焼けちゃう。残りの。
Okay, so do 3 for the first roll.2 for the second. Okay.
卵液は2回目は2杯分の卵液を流し込んで、わあっという間に焼けちゃう。残りの卵液を入れて。
He did a little bit too much. He probably should have did like two rolls, two or three rolls. That's fine. Like I said, it's going to be fine. It looks ugly compared to what a professional would do. It's still going to taste good, I'm sure.
なんかすごい適当になっちゃったけど。いや、すいません。なんかすごい適当になっちゃった。もういいや。もういいや。なんか静かになったな。なんとかできた。
白練りごま。 soft white and then goma abura. Sesame seeds. Okay. Shiro nuri goma.
白練りごま小さじ1。白すりごま小さじ1。
白すりごま。 Okay.
1醤油1たらし。 砂糖大さじ1。 塩小さじ1/2。
1たらし。 I don't think that's it. ただ。 One drop. Okay. 醤油1たらし。
砂糖醤油1たらし。
Yeah, okay, a squirt.
砂糖大さじ1。 塩小さじ1/2を。
小さじ。 half a tablespoon.
よく混ぜる。
よく混ぜる。
この水切りしておいたお豆腐を入れて。
So that's the tofu we heat up for a minute and then put the heavy stuff on to get the liquids out of it. Okay.
さらにねりねりして。
Really?
ゆでたほうれん草をおひたしぐらいに切って。 よーく水気を取って。 豆腐のあえ衣に。
あえ衣に? 豆腐のあえ衣。よーくあえる。 Let's see what あえる. To dress. Okay. Okay, dressing. よくあえる。
豆腐のあえ衣によーくあえる。あえあえ。はい、ボールでできる簡単白あえの出来上がり。 冷凍ご飯2膳分をチンして。
冷凍ご飯2膳分。食器や食べ物台。 One plate. Small dining table. One tray. Okay.
2膳分。冷凍ご飯2膳分をチンして。水でさーっと洗って。 たっぷりの水と白だしを適当に入れて。白だし?
What is that? Is that like a... Yeah, it's 白だし. Ponzu, not ponzu.
雑炊を作ります。
雑炊を作ります。雑炊を作ります。鍋が沸騰してご飯がふやけてきたら、一口大に切った鶏もも肉を入れる。いや、一枚全部入れちゃえ。
一口大に切った鶏もも肉を入れる。
Okay.
いや、一枚全部入れちゃえ。
本当？Okay. That's a lot of chicken.
おい、病人のおかゆごときにもも肉一枚使うな。
病院のおかゆ。おかゆごと。病院のおかゆごときに。
もも、おいおい、病人のおかゆごときにもも肉一枚使うな。ももは高いんだぞ、ももは。
I like the Dutch tilt. I think that's a Dutch tilt. I could be wrong.
火が通ったら味見をして、最後は卵で閉じる。三つ葉切る。
卵で閉じる。
やなきゃ。最後は卵で閉じる。三つ葉切らなきゃ。
三つ葉。Three leaves. No, no.
待て、ダメだ。生の鶏肉切ったまな板だぞ、それは。
Raw chicken? 切ってまま。Oh, oh, he didn't clean. Oh, no, no, no. Okay, I see.
うわ、これ鶏肉切ったまな板じゃん。
There you go. You don't want to cross contamination. What?
危ない、危ない。
And there's manaita. And yeah, they're not showing it here, but manaita is, instead of manaita, manaita. So that's where you really learn pitch, where Japanese pitch comes into play. You know, I think you have a lot of stress about, I think with people, you've got this a lot of debate happening over, you know, Japanese pitch accent. I think where the debate could actually beresolved quite a bit is by words like this, like mana, it's not mana, it's mana and then ita, which by themselves be pronounced that way, but we add it together like that, it's manaita. It's almost like the na and the e, so it's almost when it's there because they're at the same pitch, so the na and e becomes nai, and it sounds like manaita, 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 instead of manaita. I think if you hear that way it's pronounced, and it makes sense, like that's why you really want to be, that's why you be careful about,how pitch is done, because sometimes you want it at a separate different, when you've got the pitches are different, then it helps prevent the two syllables from blending together, whereas if they're the same pitch, they tend to blend together, and that could be important depending on the word you're trying to pronounce. Manaita is a very good example of a word where if someone just saw it like mana inita, then they'll definitely pronounce it wrong.And it could be all, and by the way, it could be off. I'm just saying, like, the way I'm hearing it pronounced by, let's say, and it may be the way it's pronounced just in standard Japanese, you know, no matter the region. So those are actually good words where it's, make sure you pronounce correctly, because it just helps when you can hear it, and then you start picking it out when you're hearing it in senses as well.
まず洗わなきゃ。うわ、これ鶏肉切ったまな板じゃん。
まな板じゃん。
まず洗わなきゃ。
まず洗わなきゃ。
手際が悪い。
手際。
手際が悪い。てか、気になって眠れない。
できた。シロー
ああ、ケンジよ。だし巻き卵に卵とじ雑炊って。
だし巻き卵。だしスタイル。Ah, there we go. Let's look this up. There we go. Cool. That makes more sense. Dashi. Dashi maki. Dashi maki tamago. Tamago doshi. Toji. Tamago toji. And porridge.ゾウスイ
だし巻き卵に卵とじ雑炊って思いっきり卵かぶってるよ
思いっきり卵かぶってるよ
ってかこの雑炊やっぱ
Make sure about it. Yeah, yeah.
鶏肉入れすぎだろ
どう食べられそうう
ん、いただきます
どうぞ
このだし巻き結構うまいな
うん OK
この卵焼き見た目ちょっとあれだけど味美味しくない？なんかお店屋さんのみたいじゃない？テレビでやったのメモっといたんだ。シロさんどう？
このだし巻き確かに。手際の悪さが見た目に表れてるけど食感ふわふわで味もいいよ
There we go OK 食感ふわふわで
本当
Looks horrible No it does say it looks horrible It looks like amateur It looks like an amateur made it Cool Which he, again amateur did But the taste is good It'sIt was the presentation that was lacking, which is no big deal when you're dealing. But again, that's a refinement. That's the thing you worry about over time. That'll happen over time.
雑炊は、お前、貴重な鶏のもも肉一枚全部使ったろ。
一枚全部使う。
ごめん。
貴重な、貴重な鶏。これのもも肉。
ごめん。
Let me hear that again, by the way.
お前、貴重な鶏のもも肉一枚全部使ったろ。
あ、ごめん。
でも、そうすれば自然とタンパク質が口に入るし。
タンパク。プロテイン、タンパク質。
でも、そうすれば自然とタンパク質が口に入るし。
Let's see the kanji again for タンパク。Yeah, it should be that.No. That's protein. Right? Tanpaku shitsu. Alright, and there's the kanji. There's tan again. Okay, tanpaku. God darn it. That's the tan of tanpaku. Okay. A puree or insects.A zoo of insects, which is again a good source of protein. There's a bunch of insects, good source of proteins. Tanpaku. And there's a tan. And then white would be the. Not that one. That one. Tanpaku. Okay, cool.
Demo, so. Demo, so すれば自然とタンパク質が口に入るし。
自然と田んぼで質を
食欲ないときは案外いいのかもなこの白あえも水っぽくなくてすご
い白あえも白あえも it's not saying what that is so 水
すごくうまいよ
ありがとう、ケンジ。
はあ、よかった。いただきます。
You're already eating.
とは言ったものの。
とは。
風邪で今一つ味がわからん。
風邪で今一つ。
風邪で今一つ味がわからん。
あ、ご飯食べたら薬飲んでね。まだ寝てなきゃダメだよ。
うん。
汗かいたでしょ。うん、
あ、着替えのスウェットあるかな。ついでにちょっとあの部屋の空気入れ替えとくね。
ケンジ、なんでそんなに俺の世話なんか焼きたがるんだろう。
焼きたがる。焼きたい。焼きたがるんだろう。
ケンジ、なんでそんなに俺の世話なんか焼きたがるんだろう。
世話なんか焼きたい。
これですね。
ええ、これです。
なんだかな、二人で会うとか言うから何かと思ったらそれか。
いらっしゃいませ。
あ、どうしたの急に。
いや、掛井さんに電話をしたら風邪がなかなか抜けないっていうもんでね。
風邪がなかなか。
将来の粉末のいいのがあるからって持ってき。
ジンジャー、生姜、
生姜、
you?
生姜の粉末のいいのがあるからって。
Okay. Yeah, that's a good way for feeling sick. Like, get shoga, a lot of ginger boiled into hot water. 粉末。
持ってきてくれたんだよ。生姜の粉末のいいのがあるからって。持ってきてくれたんだよ。
はあ。
で、わたるくんは、
なんで。だって、大ちゃんと加計さんが二人で会うとか嫌じゃん。
渡君心配性だね。大丈夫だよ、僕は渡君一筋分かってるだろ。
分か
っ、
心配性。Let's see. I know that's like, don't worry, I don't. 心配性。苦労様。Being worried excessively. Prone to worrying. 心配性。Okay.
大丈夫だよ、僕は渡る。渡君心配性だね。大丈夫だよ、僕は渡君一筋分かってるだろ。
一筋。Let's see. One.
One. 大丈夫だよ、僕は渡君一筋分かってるだろ。
分かんないよ、そんなの。証明してみせてよ。
言わないで。だからこうやってちゃんと渡君を呼んでるじゃないの。
あの
もうほっとけ、ね、毎度のプレイだから。
わかる、
毎度のプレイだ
から。何
これ。で、加計さんは今までどんな人と付き合ってきたの。
毎度のプレイだから。
いいよ、いい年したおっさん二人が躊躇する話でもない。
躊躇。 I thought that was pronounced something differently though.
なに、よいい年したおっさん二人が躊躇する話でもないでしょ。
それなりに。
Keep free. I mean, because I've seen these, you know, I remember, you know, these kanji pop up in the other stories as well. It's not a very, that is not an easy kanji there. The next one is, so this one is, but hesitate. So the way I would do it, if you were doing, by the way, the way I would mention it, if you ever do RTK, like in the later levels, like if you do it in parts like I recommend, simple to more difficult, no, more common, more frequency, by frequency groups, either by 500 frequency groups or 200 frequency groups, whatever you feel like. But when you get up to this point, like with bada, grapes, I'm sorry, with rose or grapes or this right here, where it's two kanji, and they're basically the only time those kanji appear is in this one particular word. And instead of like trying to think of two different words to represent one word, to say, hey, have it be rose one, rose two, means this is the kanji for the first part of rose, this is the kanji for the second part of rose, or grape one, grape two. This is the kanji for the first part of budo, this is for the second half of budo. Or in like here, it's like hesitate one, hesitate two. That would be a better way of doing it, and try to think of, instead of trying to think of, you're just thinking, hey, what is the first kanji for hesitate? So you just think of the story for the first part of hesitate. And then you can also, that can help you with the second part of hesitate. And that'll also help you keep the kanji straight when you're having to write them out for, if you ever decide to write out from memory, which can be useful for it. Again, if you, there are some benefits being able to know how to write kanji from memory. Because again, Japanese adults know how to do that. No, they're not. It's like spelling tests, though. Obviously, most U.S. adults are not going to be able to pass the, are not going to be able to score high in a spelling bee. Something that's dedicated specifically for, spelling very complicated, rarely used words. Words, for example. But I guarantee you, most of the U.S. adults can't spell. So same thing with Japanese adults. They're not may not be able to like pass the kanji kente level one, which is like 6,000 kanji and 60,000, or 6,000 kanji and maybe 60,000, 80,000, out of 60,000, 80,000 words. This is, but they could probably do it with out of 2,000 kanji and 22,000 words, for example, or 3,000 kanji and 35,000 words. There might be quite a few Japanese people that can then do that as well. That's like the one prior to level one kanji kente. So I'm saying, like, you will also kind of like when you hear about pitch accent, there's this debate. My reasons behind saying you need to know how to, you should know how to write kanji from memory is that, and the average adult, Japanese adult, knows how to write kanji and knows how to write words using kanji. They know how to do that. What I'm saying is, like, you don't have to go to an extreme that goes beyond the level an adult has, but you should at least try to approach a level an adult has. That to me makes sense. Yeah, you're right. There, Dorian Peters, like, yeah, there's two different words using it. Same kanji. Yeah, I'm not gonna remember that. Chu cho and, but you do see it in hesitate. So that's just, so this word has popped up quite a few times in those kanji. And those kanji are becoming more common because you, with or without furigana. But by the way, thank you for that. In fact, let me see. In fact, when he was like, there we go, tamerao. That's the word I'm remembering it for. So, chu cho, tamerao. There you go. Yep. So, anyway, let's continue on. Masui-fun. Wakazu, wakazu. Let's see. No, wakazu. Keiken no, a variety of experiences, right? Experience. Wakazu. Okay. So, yeah, wakazu.
それなりに場数踏んできたんでしょ？
そう。
じゃあ、ざっとまとめると、んなタイプの人が多かった？じゃあ、ざっとまとめると、
ざっと make sure about.
どんなタイプの人が多かった？
まあどっちかっていうと無口なやつが多かったかな。まあどっちかっていうと無口なやつが多かったかな。何考えても分かんない感じの。いい人そうっていうよりはちょっと冷たそうな。
それって全部ケンちゃんとは正反対じゃん。ケイちゃん全然掛け算タイプじゃないじゃん。
What?
いや、それは。
渡るくん、そんな言い方しちゃうと角が立つよ。
あーでもあれか、タイプじゃないのにケンちゃんを選んだってことは、
うん、
逆にケンちゃんかなり家計さんに愛されてるんだもんね。
そうだよね、好みじゃないのに付き合ってんだもんね。やだ、もう嬉しい。行こう。
はしゃぐな、はしゃぐな。ジルベール渡る。
しゃぐ。Oh yeah, being excited, that's right. はしゃぐな、はしゃぐな。
天然の小悪魔なのか。
It's like, Tenden is usually like stupid, stupid devil or stupid goblin. Not natural there. I think this means being, can also be like stupid. Spacey, there we go. Tenden. And then, Koakuma is like, oh yeah, a little imp. Tenden no Koakuma.
Jirubeeru Wataru. Tenden no Koakuma nano ka, sore tomo honki de sokoeji ga warui no ka.
Sokoeji ga. Sokoeji.そこ意地が、
それとも本気でそこ意地が悪いのかわからん。
そういうケンちゃんはどんなタイプが好きなの？
俺はね、シティハンターのサイバリオ。
シティハンター、 I don't know. サイバル、バリオ、サイバ、サイ、あ、サイバ、サイバリオ。
え？
シティハンター。
それこの世の内が異次元の人だもん。
4人はいない。There's no new world. 二次元、例えば、2-dimensional 二次元アニメ。God damn it. Anime, Nijigen, two-dimensional character. Nijigen, though. I don't know if he's telling you, hey, it's an anime character or,
Ita no. それこの世にはいないが、異次元の人だもん。Ita no.
え？え？ここに三次元のサイバリオが。
Three-dimensional. Okay, so, they, so I think, okay, Nijigen is meaning anime, which...I'm gonna probably, I know that was mentioned before in Steins Gate, because there was a lot of the words in Steins Gate, I didn't get the references, because I don't read these, again, a lot of these visual novels or these novels aimed at teens and junior high kids. So, where I guess a lot of that vocabulary is much more common. Okay, but Nijigen, Sanjigen.
Shiro-san, when I first met you,俺分かったの。ああ、ここに俺のりょうちゃんがいたって。
似てないって思ってる。全力で思ってる。
え、何？いい匂い。もしかしてシロさん。ケーキ焼いてる？
うん。
え、嘘。ついにスイーツに手出したんだ。とうとう乙女の世界に来たんだ。
乙女。I know it's like girl. Jose. Young. Okay, 乙女の。
違うよ。
とうとう乙女の世界に来たんだ。
違うよ。安売りの時に買ったホットケーキミックスが賞味期限ギリギリだったから。
Show me Keegan. Oh yeah, I know it's like the, show me Keegan. I know that's like, that's supposed to be the, sell by date, expiration date. Show me Keegan. Giri giri.
Show me Keegan, giri giri だったから. Show me Keegan, giri giri.
安売りの時に買ったホットケーキミックスが賞味期限ギリギリだったから、あとバナナも黒くなり始めたし。あのな、それは小日向さんに何かお貸ししないとまずいと思ったんだよ。もらった生姜油調べたら、なんか新鮮の結構高いやつだったから。
新鮮の
なんかもらった生姜油調べたら、なんか新鮮の結構高いやつだったから。
新鮮、新鮮、新鮮の結構高いやつ。
さすが小日向さん。
ケーキ屋の詰め合わせなんて買ったらまた高くつくだろう。
とか言ってケーキ型まで買っちゃってるじゃんよ。
しかも二つも。
ミートローフ作るのに使えると思ったんだよ。ひき肉料理のレパートリーも増やしたかったし。
もう素直じゃないんだ。
にしてもいい匂いだね。
にしても、にしても。To make sure about that, それは今というような。
このバターの甘い匂いだけは家でケーキ焼かないと楽しめないんだよな。
だよね。
Banana bread.
Banana たっぷり。バターたっぷりで美味しい。これならきっと喜んでもらえるね。
まあこれぐらいのお返しの方が負担にならなくていいだろう。お前の入浴剤と一緒で。
入浴剤、入浴剤、お前の入浴剤と一緒
に。お前の入浴剤。まあこれぐらいのお返しの方が負担にならなくていいだろう。お前の入浴剤と一緒で。
そうだね、これぐらいがいいよね。
俺さ、お前のああいうとこ本当見習わないとなって思ってんだよね。気が利くっていうかさ。
気が利く、気が利くっていう、
気が利くっていうかさ、相手の重荷にならない気遣いさらっとするだろう。
気遣いさらっと。Please notice. Oh, quickly. 気遣いさらっとするだろう。Let's see if that's full phrase. Okay, so no, it's not. 重荷にならない。
相手の重荷にならない気遣いさらっとするだろう。
なんか最近シロさんがちょっとだけこっち側に来てくれてるみたいで嬉しいよ。
こっち側って？
うん、小日向さんたちに頻繁に会ったり。
小日向、小日向、Maybe it was Kohinata. Yeah, that one. I'm gonna say it's Kohinata.
Kohinata-san たちに頻繁に会ったり、お返し作ったり。
たま。
お返し作ったり。Let's make about that.
またまだよ。
あー、でも渡るくんってやっぱ意外といい子だと思わない？
そうか。
だってシロさんが実は俺のことすごく愛してるって。
言ってくれたでしょ。
ね、だからあれは
シロさんの口から絶対そういうの聞けないから言ってもらえて嬉しかった。
そういう話をつるっとされるから嫌なんだよ。
つるっと、
言ってもらえて嬉しかった。
そういう話をつるっとされるから嫌なんだよ。
甘い、幸せ。
でもまあおかげで俺もケンジがどうして俺なのかって疑問が解けたわけだけど、
シロさんと初めて会った時俺分かったの。はあ、ここに俺のリョウちゃんがいたって。
なんてことはない。俺に一目惚れだったってわけだ。
一目惚れ、fall in love with the look、 一目惚れだったわけだ。
なんてことはない。俺に一目惚れだったってわけだ。
何シロさん、何その不気味な笑い。どうしたの。気になる。あら、食べていいの。ちょっともう遅いけどいいの。
うん、何これ、小日向さんから。
あちょあっあっ
あっあ
っあっ
あっあっあっあ、え、小日向さんとちょくちょく会ってたのって。
ちょくちょく frequently every now once a ちょくちょく会って、
これが目的とちょくちょく会ってたのって、これが目的。え、じゃあ何、これお返しって、これこっちのお返し。
いやいやいや、たまたまだよ、たまたま余ってたから。
え、ちょっと待って、じゃあシルさんってやっぱ女好きなんじゃん。
女じゃない。俺が好きなのは三ツ矢真美だ。
何それ。はい、じゃあ何、三ツ矢真美に言われたら付き合うの。
言われたら新しくなろうとして店へ近づく。あ、オッケー。いい夜、寄られたら、
え、言われたら三ツ矢真美に言われたら付き合うの。
え、
あ、考えた。
ないって
ば。三ツ矢真美のことちょっと今考えたんですよ。
ない、もう考えた。あ、ダメ。あ、
ちょっと待って。ファイヤーの女も継続中。
え、継続中ないから。Continuation, renewal, okay. パン屋のオノも。Oh, okay, got it. 継続中。
パン屋
のオノ
も継続中？よしくん、こっち。私最近。
よしくん。
調味料も
全。私最近調味料。
最近調味料も全部オーガニックに変えたんですよ。
初めから言えよ。あの人たちがそういう目的で俺と会いたがってたって。
Let's see. So I came out, so it's an hour 15. Yeah, so these are being very consistent about how long it's taken to watch. So it's coming up to roughly about hour 10, hour and 15 minutes to take to get through each of these 30 minutes. So again, roughly about 2 to 1. A little bit over that because, again, this is a bit more dense, it seems. A lot more dialogue, so very little downtime in between what's being spoken. So it kind of makes sense there. But yeah, I think doing one episode a day is kind of good for me as far as it's concerned. I might Yeah, sometimes I'll try to do two episodes, but I think I've only did that once, and it's that comes out to like it feels like it's like 3 hours of streaming. Well, you know, getting prep time, doing the recording, then doing the set downtime after that, but then doing the prep time for the next video, it comes up to like over 3 hours of stuff I got to be doing, you know, online for this. Let me stop out of that. But yeah, like I'll just talk about again. The show is still. It's still great. It's a very good, lighthearted comedy. This one, it was kind of cool because it fairly straightforward to follow along with. Beginning part, obviously, I spent a lot of time in because they were talking fast and with the whatever particular conversation was going on. Then the later dinner when they're talking about types, again, when they went and had dinner a little bit later. That took a little. That added a little bit extra time trying to figure out what the hell was being said. Got it. But yeah, for the most part, these are. I'm feeling like, is this really more difficult than all the other ones? I'm gonna say no. It's just because there's a lot more. It's more text heavy or more dialogue heavy. It's just gonna take a little bit more time. But it's still roughly about 2 to 1, about the amount of time, all things considered. Sid and Carton, can I ask you how long you've been studying Japanese? And again, that's a very complicated question because I started and stopped, and then even now I'm kind of half-assed doing it. I mean, even now this is half-assed. Like this part right here isn't. I mean, it's technically studying, but it's not like studying to try to memorize words. So like you know, you come up with like tamerao or chucho or something like whatnot. Like that word is. I'm probably gonna forget it. For example. Because I'm not going to go through the steps to put into Anki and try to make the efforts to memorize it. I'm going to be doing different things for that. Now, later on, I'm sure there will be a point where you want to start sentence mining for myself, you know, especially sentence, but the sentence mining will be less about vocabulary, more for phrases. Yeah, there's still knowing more words is always going to be a good thing. Knowing more words is always going to be a good thing, but for it's also important about phrases, and there's probably phrases that are better to know than vocabulary, you know, but it's hard to find the good balance between those two. But then there's always going to be a part when it comes to output, and I get the feeling a lot of the things when dealing with output, it's going to really come down to getting a tutor. It's not like, oh, I'm going to naturally be able to say stuff, which is fine, but you then want that native there, that native to then catch all the mistakes you're making, which you're going to be making mistakes, and then smooth those out. You know, and it shouldn't be too hard. Like for every, when you work with a tutor, and a tutor's, but specifically be for speaking, and not about learning anything new. It's just about saying something you want to say, and then basically you're just developing 5 minute speeches every week. Every lesson can be like a 5 minutes of speech, and you know, just working on that, practice on the pronunciation and the. Giving it in, or either maybe even memorizing how to say it instead of like reading it off of paper, you know, and then you get used to saying it without reading it, or maybe with referencing to a note, and then that's just 5 minutes, and then keep adding on to that an additional 5 minutes every hour of lesson, and you know, within a few lessons, you know, you can actually have within like 10 lessons you can develop like an hour's worth of material of you just speaking about something about yourself, you know. And it hopefully sounds a lot more natural, that 1 hour of you just talking. And the benefit there is also most of that information of what you speaking for an hour is probably stuff you'll be drawing upon when you're in just normal conversations. When you know, somebody asks you about something, you know, something about your daughter or your father or your job or where you live or a particular hobby you have, you can draw upon that particular speech you already had, that one section of that one speech, you know, and then say that. And then, because obviously you don't give an hour-long speech when you're talking to someone. You do sentences at a time and then get a reply back and whatnot. But you have something to draw upon that feels natural because you've practiced saying it. And it's something that applies to you. And it's not something like, oh, you need to be the one to write it out. You could, but as part of the tutoring process, like they could be the one to write it out for you. You know, you're saying, hey, this is what I am in. What I want to say in, let's say, English or whatnot, or you can add, even if you do type it out in Japanese, then they can then do the smoothing process where they say, here, let's make this sound much more natural for you, a foreign person speaking Japanese. which and it depends on the type of foreign person you are. You know, a young child is different than a, you know, an older adult. All right. That said, I think, oh, and I was just kind of mentioned about that, but yeah, to kind of put down, it's random about me studying Japanese. So yeah, I started roughly around 12, was it actually more than 12 years ago. Did it for like 2 to 3 years, tried to do it seriously, but I made a lot of mistakes during that time. That stopped for around 6 years in the middle, tried to start back up slowly about 4 or 5 years ago, maybe more than that, but slowly got back into wanting to learn, you know, relearning what I had forgotten over those 6 years, and then trying to get really into, you know, maybe sometimes getting serious, but then stopping for a few months at a time. So even then, it's like, again, there's no way, you know, if I said, oh, I've been studying for 15 years, that's obviously a fucking lie. If I started 15 years ago, I've been on and off since then, if that makes sense. People who want to make fun of me, they'll mention just when I started, and they'll say, oh, he's just a dumbass. He can't learn Japanese because, again, he's been doing this for 15 years and he still sucks. That's a trollish type of insult. Whereas they're saying, like, you can look at what I've done, and I've done some really stupid shit when it comes to learning, and things that have probably wasted more time than the benefit they would have gained. But there are some things that made sense. But also realize when I started, a lot of stuff is being developed that now exists. It's like, it's an everyday thing. Anki was being developed around the time I was started Japanese. The Core 2K that was a very popular vocabulary list to learn vocabulary, had not been released like a year after I'd started. Same with kind of Anki. We started about roughly the year I'd started. That's when the Damien Elms actually came out with Anki. Sub-ZSRS came out the, I want to say that year also. Let's see, 2007. Yeah, I want to say, yeah, around about 2007, I think, Buzanki was starting to come out as well. But yeah, a lot of stuff was starting to come out that now is standard tools that make learning it, you know, for someone like me who didn't do the immersion the way that Matt Hurt Japan did or Katsumoto did, which definitely was a much better benefit, which I think now that, you know, when I think about it, it's very simple. Like, they were probably just doing what I'm doing here, maybe not using pop-up dictionaries, but, you know, they were just watching it, maybe reading. They were reading a lot more, obviously, you know, looking at them. They were doing Anki a lot more seriously than I was. And my idea, like, when I first did with Katsumoto, I'm thinking, like, what is sentence mining? He was saying the 10,000 sentences, that's what you need. So I thought, okay, let's gather 10,000 sentences first, and that's what you needed. No, that's not what you need. What you need to is, like, you build sentences one by one. You know, you collect what, all right, so it's got to be a personal thing, because what you, your I plus one is going to be different for everybody else. So having a collection of sentences wasn't really about it, wasn't it. That said, though, having a structured at the beginning would much better than what he was trying to do. What Katsumoto and Maverick Japan, when he first started, was giving, I would say, was bad advice, was saying, hey, learn all the, do the RTK first. Not a good idea. RTK first is, as a full-blown RTK, all 2,000 kanji, or what Matt was saying, 3,000 kanji. Again, this is what Matt at the beginning was saying, but he changed the opinion on that. But there were some ideas, or there could be a very structured way of going about it, you know. And you can have that very basic beginning structure there and then go through that. Then anyone who's doing it is now prepped to do the sentence mining in a smart way, because they have a baseline, a structured baseline, and then from there go to sentence mining. Or actually, even if they want to, then do sentence mining and continue on with the structured, or just do the structured. But then after that baseline is done, you know, what I would say, like, the first 200 study hours, where you're trying to get your vocabulary up to 2,000, you're trying to get your basic grammar, the equivalent of Taikim or Genki or whatever, that basic grammar of what is Japanese, getting that under your belt, so you can kind of comprehend what's happening with these words inside a sentence. And, you know, basic kanji, you know, maybe you don't need 2,000 kanji, but, you know, 300 to 500 most basics is reasonable to have. From that basic things, and yeah, you can then go into where you can actually be doing immersion and having fun. Because I was doing the immersion without the comprehension, and to Katsumoto, he said, well, when the magic happens, because it's going to happen. No, it doesn't happen. You need that comprehension. Without that comprehension, your brain's not making the connections that needs to happen to really get into it, to start realizing stuff. But that's what I realized through all this studying was it. And actually even restarting, I realized like what the mistakes were and what can be done to like fix those mistakes for beginners who are just starting now. And I think it works. I mean, what Matt said, suggests people do, and I've seen people like follow my suggestions and they've actually done pretty well. And they actually do better than I do because they put in the time, much more time than I've put into it. So that's how that works. When you get to a point where it's all about time, you know, you consuming comprehensible Japanese, you know, that's really what it boils down to. And this all can be explained like, hey, what you do at the basics and beginnings, and what you do at the intermediate, and what you do at the advanced, and then after the advanced stage is also what you do when you're trying, now you're approaching for the fluent literate stage. Because the advanced stage is still, M1 is not fluent literate in Japanese, it's advanced. So you're still not native level fluency literacy. Now we're not saying sound like a native, we just means like you understand anything a native could understand, and that's all right, because you're not, the idea of sounding like a native is kind of a misnomer, because accents are going to be really hard to overcome, but that's not language. That's not something you got to worry about with the language, because accents happen all over the place. But for the input, the comprehension of when you hear something or when you read something, can you comprehend it? That would be, could you comprehend what a native adult speaker would comprehend? I would think that's native level fluency. I think that's a reasonable, line. Now, how to gauge that is really fucking difficult. But, you know, again, if you're enjoying Japanese media with, like right now, obviously I'm not at native level fluency because I still need to like pause, reread, look up some words. I am not at a native level anywhere close to it. But again, what's going to happen is if I consume more of the material, you know, we're talking thousands of hours of consuming material, comprehensible material, then yeah, I will approach that native level. You know, both the ability to read, my reading's better than my listening, but they're all still lacking in fluency and literacy. But, you know, again, it's going to be pushed higher and higher. Part of that's also going to be with learning vocabulary. So, and it's a fine balance. And I'll say that again, when I was doing this, all this learning, it's like learning that balance. What needs to be done at a bit for a beginner? What needs to be done with someone like myself, which is higher intermediate, approaching the advanced stages? Is just going to be slightly different. But especially the immersion. The immersion is like, as you keep going further and further, the more the important the immersion becomes, as opposed to just, you know, adding another 100 words to your vocabulary repertoire or learning some more grammatical techniques. That, you know, those are useful and whatnot, but really it's going to be, you know, the 100 hours you've done, the more shows and the more books that you read, which I'm not doing. If you look at the amount of time I spent in English on this, and it's obvious you can follow that along. Just look at my Reddit post. You know how much time I'm spending in the English speaking community. That's why I'm not getting at a higher level as opposed to someone like Matt, who was always doing a lot more in Japanese than I ever was. And so he got better faster. Okay. And again, you probably stopped listening to my answer way back when, but yeah, I needed to get that out because part of this is that helps me because I'm like realizing like, yeah, I'm really fucking up here by, you know, putting in all this effort with the studying aspect, but then if I'm not putting in any of the time needed for that immersion, then it's not, I'm kind of going to lose all the effort I'm putting in because eventually, you know, I might give up on the studying part. And then if the immersion isn't there, then all of a sudden it all starts collapsing again. Okay. So a way I would also put it is like, my vocabulary was around maybe about 8,000 active words. So again, it's like, like I said, it's like, I might have a hard time passing the N2 test. I'll put it that way. So again, nowhere near what needs to be done. Some things I'll do great on, some things I won't. You know, I might do better on the kanji, some vocabulary than others. Maybe I'll fucking suck on the grammar side of things. And maybe the reading I'll be all right. Listening I will just be horrible at. you know, just the way it is. But yeah, I'm having fun. That's the main thing. Hey, I'm having fun. And let's just continue having fun. That's the biggest thing. I like this show. I've watched it. I was watching it again last night with my wife because we were just like from episode 2 onward. And yeah, I was just having fun, sitting down, eating dinner, watching the show. And that's just kind of the immersion. That's the normal type of passive immersion that's fun. And you know, it's not me having to, because I've already done these let's reads, I don't have to go and ask why, if there was something I didn't quite get, I didn't have to worry about it because I already got it because I already looked that part up. And if there was something that I was thinking of prior, then I could ask her about it because it's like, oh yeah, I was thinking about that during my study time. So asking that one thing doesn't bother somebody else as opposed to if it was like asking every other thing, like what's that? And plus she likes to cook. So asking her like about some of the cooking aspects, you know, is a really good conversation to have. A lot of this is incomprehensible to me, but I feel I'm improving. Yeah, same thing. I mean, if you're not at my level, this might, or around my level, this could be either too advanced or too boring, too slow. But if you're around my level, which is around high end 3, low end 2, around there, you know, maybe around 6,000, 8,000 known vocabulary words in your, if you do Morphman analysis of your Anki decks, for example, something like that, then you might, it might not be the thing you want to watch. But what I'm doing works, once you're past that basics of 2,000 words and basic grammar, everyone can be doing this. You might not want to do it with you might want to start with easy anime. Slice of Life anime, or if you can find on maybe some translated anime that are from children's shows, you know, to kind of start basic, but make sure it shows that you might still enjoy watching. I usually recommend Peppa Pig. Problem is there's no subtitles for Peppa Pig. There are transcripts that can be found. I've linked to those before. So you could do that. And eventually I'm going to go and actually get those transcripts put in a way towards just Japanese, because the transcripts are Japanese, English, Japanese, English, Japanese, English. So I need to get towards just the Japanese transcripts. And I might even plan to do a let's read of Peppa Pig that way, which I think would be cool because there's 60 transcripts available on that one blog. So if I do about the equivalent of 5 shows, an episode or a video, I'll do 5 shows a video. Yeah, that could be, you know, 12 parts. That's a good series right there. And I think that could actually be very popular for people who are beginning Japanese. Because of the, you know, we saw that it's like, oh yeah, this makes complete sense. And then go back and watch Peppa Pig in Japanese by itself, you realize, yeah, this is like high level comprehension for me. And this is really good for immersion. And it's about, again, 60 episodes. That comes out to about 5 hours of good Japanese to immerse in. And you might then find some other children's shows that are similar to what was Peppa Pig, but hopefully have transcripts available. Where you can, again, you can make sure like it's already at a good level of comprehension. The comprehension is already going to be high because of the way the story, you know, again, you can just watch the show and not understand a lick of, you can just watch it in Chinese and you can still kind of follow along with what the story is about. But it helps to know like what all the words are that are being said so that when you hear it again, you're already prepped yourself into, you know, what are the words and phrases that are going to be coming up for in this particular episode. Anyway, hopefully that makes sense. Okay. I think I'm going to call that a day. Thank you all very much. It's been Nuke Marine. Let's read Japanese. Kino Nani Tabita, episode 7. Wow, we're already an hour and a half. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and like. Make a comment. Sure. Feedback's welcome. If you like the series, you can subscribe and I can set a channel and see a lot more and make a lot more series like this. If you like this part of the Let's Learn Japanese project, if you like what I'm doing there, you can subscribe to the Patreon, links below, along with the links to the website and the community Discord. Finally, there's also links for hiring me on commission. The hourly rates and the payments are done via Patreon as well, but a direct link for that is below. All right. I'll be back with episode 8. So approaching, getting closer and closer to the end of this one and coming back. Now I'm going to do Shinya Shokuto. I've got an idea what the next episode is going to be. It might, after Shinya Shokuto season 2, it might be one of those that you got to give a viewer discretion warning, because it's like just because the content of the particular show, it's not the Naked Director, but it's going to be something of a. But I think it might be an interesting video to watch, so I'm looking forward to that. It's yeah, one of those supposed Netflix originals or something like that. Yeah, all right, cool. And with that, thank you all very much, and I will see you next time. Let me just say thanks to Cindy Carton and Dorian Peters for your comments. They're appreciated, and thanks for watching. Spell that correctly. Thanks for watching. Later, guys.